I started practicing my autograph when I was 12 because I just always felt, because we were poor, and I always felt that being poor was such a drag because it was like, I felt that somehow that we were poor, that it was my fault, or that like people, like if your clothes weren't good or you know, you looked tacky, you looked as good as you could with what you had to do, you know, but I always thought, when I grow up, I'm going to be somebody. I really wasn't sure how because I didn't know how to do anything.
And did you think only because you were poor, or were there other elements?
Sure. I was really ugly, too. I mean, just really, you know, I went to my mom once, and I said, my mother's blonde and my sister's blonde. And I said, how come I'm dark, and I have an ugly nose, and I have these teeth, and they're no, you know, what is, you know, and my mother said, let me tell you something. She said, when you grow up, she said, you're not going to be the most beautiful. You're not going to be the most charming. She said, you're not going to be the most anything. She said, but when I look at you, she said, there's something about you that's different. And she said, so don't worry about it. And which was the hippest thing that she ever said to me. I mean, it was just really something that it didn't register then, but when I think back on it now, it's true. I'm none of those things. I'm not the most beautiful or the most talented or any of those things, but I know, I feel that there's something about me that's different. And then I met Sonny, and I really liked him. He was really the strangest man I'd ever met.
Did he make a pact with you right away?
He did. You know what he told me? He said, you know what? I like your personality, but you're not really good looking. And I swear. And I'll never forget, we were going to go swimming. And he said, go put your bathing suit on. And he came running in with anticipation and all that, and he looked at me and he said, my God, look at you, your skin and bones. He said, you got to eat or do something, is that it? And I said, yes, that's it. You know, I was really bummed out. And so he held my hand 3 months after I knew him. We were in a movie, and in the middle of this movie, he held my hand. And I thought, what does this mean? But whatever it was, I liked him, and I liked it, and it was really terrific. And then this kind of strange relationship started to develop. I never met a man like Sonny. I never will meet a man like Sonny. I mean, he's really unique unto himself. I married Sonny when I was 16, and I didn't grow up until after I had the baby.
At 15, 16, when you married Sonny, what did you think marriage was going to be all about?
I thought that he was a good man, and I liked him, and I loved him, and I thought that he would take good care of me. Which he did.
The classic question. Was he like your father? Was he like a father?
He was like my mother, my sister, my brother, I said, Sonny, you and I are to each other. There is no name for our relationship. We were like all parts of a family, but none of them. I always thought that I was the minutest part of Sonny and Cher. And then when I had to do things on my own without Sonny, and I started being able to do a few things on my own, I figured, well, I'm not as dumb as I thought I was, and I'm not as weak as I thought I was. And I'm like 25. I'm like still like a 25, 16-year-old, you know? I didn't know how to make out a check. I was so used to Sonny taking care of everything, you know? He knew everything, and he was usually right. I didn't have to make any decisions.
I'm in love right now.
Oh, gosh, how nice. You're telling me something. You are in love right now.
It's real dumb.
Why is it dumb?
I don't know, because I feel like, I don't know if it's, who can tell if it's lasting love? And also, that's another thing. Love, you know, don't push it. Let it go on its own, and what will happen. Love is after you've been with someone, and the newness wears off, and you still love them, and you like them, and you find things. That's love. Right now, I'm in like, you know, which is really also a terrific feeling. If I go to bed with somebody, I want to have something to talk to them about afterwards. I want to be in love or have that feeling. I might have made a mistake after 3 months or 4 months, but I want to know that there's some kind of communication, because sex without it, to me, is just, it's not, I can't even do it. I mean, I thought, when I left Sonny, I thought, well, I'm going to be a liberated woman. I'm going to go out and I'm going to meet a man. If I want to, I will. I couldn't do it. It's not my way.